Well, welcome everybody. I'm Paolo, and this is episode 4 in our line dance series. Today's theme is on the Shim Sham, the Lindy Hoppers Shim Sham. Now, I'm so thrilled we're able to release this today in May, the birthday month of Frankie Manning. After all, it was Frankie who arranged and choreographed this version of the Shim Sham. Now, I learned this over 20 years ago by attending the New York Swing Dance Society, and it was there on a Sunday night when you'd see Frankie Manning leading a packed crowd of enthusiastic dancers in the Shim Sham. It was a great thrill to be there. It was a great thrill to be amongst such a living legend of Lindy Hop. If there's anything I can share today, it's his passion and love for this dance. All right, so here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna have two dance team members showcasing this. One facing the river, one facing you. So get up and join us, and we'll try it out. Afterwards, we'll break down some of the steps, especially for the newbies, so you can pick it up and learn it. And those of you who already know it, well, maybe you'll pick up a styling tip or two. Does that sound good? Well, get your dance shoes on, and let's get started. Come on. Shim Sham is the stomp off. It's an easy step to do for Lindy Hoppers because it's done like this. And so essentially you're doing is you're stomping your foot and sliding it towards you. Now the sequence is this, and I'll do it from this angle. You stomp on the right, slide, stomp on the left, slide, and then you do two on the right. Now how easy is that? But let's put it together in a sequence because we're going to be alternating. We start out with the right leg. And a 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, 6, 7. And we reverse it. Now I do 2 on the left. And a single, 2 on the right. And that moves into what we call the Shim Sham break. So let's do that one more time. I'll face you. We'll take it from the top. The stomp offs. 5, 6, and 7. Stomp and slide. Stomp and slide. 2 on the right. Stomp and slide. Stomp and slide. 2 on the left. Stomp and slide. Stomp and slide. 2 on the right. Into the Shim Sham break. Now, no worries, I'm going to go over it one more time and I'm going to break down the Shim Sham break. We'll be doing the classic Lindy Hop or Shim Sham break. And for this one, you'll also start on count eight. Now, count eight, five, six, and seven, eight, we'll step onto the right foot from this angle, eight. And I'll bring my feet together for one. Step and step again together from the counts. Five, six, and seven, and a one, two, and three. Now don't transfer the weight. Bring your right foot back. Four, five, and then six, seven. Right foot, left foot. From this angle. And a one, two, and three, four, and five, six, and seven. Again from this angle, count it with me. Six and seven, and a one, four and five, six and seven. Now you'll notice I'm putting a little twist in this, and that's my styling for this. It's a little swivel action. Now the stomp offs can be done closer to the version of the tap dancers, and if you want to add that little detail, which is wonderful, then this is what you need to do. Now watch carefully. After I stomp, I'm going to pull the foot back with the toe up and then slap that toe onto the ground. It's a flap in tap dance. So again, from the heel position like this, as I bring that foot towards me, I'm going to snap hitting the toe. Now this was the way the tap dancer could create those sounds, and it looked like this. And you can sort of hear it as I'm touching the ground with the ball of the foot as well as the heel. All the way through. Five, six, and seven. And a one, two, and three, four, and five, six, and seven. And a one, two, and three, four, and two on the left. And a one, two, three, two on the right. And into the shim, sham, break, swivel, back, swivel, forward. And those are the stop-offs. The pushes and crossover sequence. I'll face you on the first time around. We're going to push it and push it and push, kick, cross, over. Now, let's take it from this angle so you can join me. I'm going to be pushing on the right foot and with the arms pushing. Pushing into the right foot, pushing, pushing, kick, cross over. I'm going to do the same thing to the left. Push, 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 kick, cross over. Now the counts are one, two, and three, four, and five, six, and seven. Let's do that one more time from this position. Starting on count eight, five, six, and seven, and a one, two, and three, push and kick and cross over. Now this way, push it once, push it twice, push it, kick, cross, over. And then we have the third, push it once, push it twice, push it, kick, cross over. And then we do two crosses only, no pushes, kick, cross over, and kick, cross over. Where we hold this position. So, you've seen the pushes and the crossovers. Try to do it with me this time, and we'll count it out. Remember, on count eight, we start the push. Make sure you're nice and flexed, so we have a lot of balance. Use your legs, use your knees. Awesome. Here goes. Five, six, and seven. Push it once, push it twice, and we kick, cross over. Push it once, push it twice, and we kick, cross over. Eight, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Eight, one, two, three, four, five, six, and seven and eight we hold. Wonderful. Now I mentioned before that we would show you a little detail on the pushes that the tap dancer would do. So let's take a look at that. as I do my two pushes, I prep for the crossover by using a flap. In tap dance, it looks like this. Flap step. And a one, two, and three, four, and five. There's the flap. And then six, seven. Again from this side. And a one, two, and three, four, and flap, step over. Now that was turned into a kick for the Lindy Hoppers, since you couldn't really hear all those little footwork steps without taps. But it's still fun to do, and if you want to build your vocabulary and skills in tap dancing, you should try to do your pushes with that little detail. Let's try it from this position with the tap dancer detail. Five, six, and seven. And a one, two, and three, four, and flap, six, seven. And a one, two, and three, and a flap, six, seven. And a one, two, three, four, and flap, six, seven. And a flap, cross over, and a flap, and freeze. Five, six, seven, you hold. Go right into the next jazz step, which is the tacky Annie. Next is the tacky Annie. Now for this dance, you're gonna get nice and low. Get lots of flex down here. So we're gonna mimic what Annie used to do, just like this. Now from this position, what I'm gonna do first is a stomp off, and it looks like this, right, left. Right, left, it's a quick step, two steps in a row, quick, quick, and you stomp them, and that's called the stomp off. We need that for each sequence of eight that we do in the tacky Annie. Stomp off. Stomp off. Now, to get out of it, we step and cross, and that preps us for the next Shim Sham break. Let's look at that one more time. So this would be the third and final tacky Annie. Five, six, and seven, stomp off. A one, two, and three, four, and five, six, and this is where we do that little preliminary step, seven. That's the prep step for the Shim Sham break. Now we're ready because our weight's on the left. Shim Sham break. How easy is that? One more time from this angle here, from here. Five, six, and seven. Stomp off. We have one, three, five, six, seven. Stomp off. Two, two, three, and five, six, seven. Stomp off. Three, two, three. Here it comes, five, six, seven. Cross that left over the right, preps you for the Shim Sham break. And a tap, tap, swivel back, swivel forward. Thank you very much for joining me for this lesson today. It was a spectacular day along the Hudson River. I hope you enjoyed. Now practice, practice, practice. Buona giornata. Ciao.